money tree to take your stress away. Ballin' like every day. Call me coach, gotta switch up plays. Spend a little money, don't care how it's made. Drop top, cool, catch sun ray. Start off with attic, gotta get it one day. Doing 200 on the runway. Got a bad chick, and she ripping the runway. It's Super Bowl Sunday. Rip out my heart, you're a demon. I get the money for real no reason. Why everybody come through unpolitely? I ride around in exotic. Wake me up, cause I gotta be dreaming. If only my dogs could see this.
I ain't never had no money. I've been out here trying to get me away. Ain't nobody helping, I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I ball. Man, like every day, hey. For all the time nobody helped me, said I ball on you. Man, like every day, hey.
Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to the Pacific Northwest, the home of the 12s, and they are in full roar as you get a look inside Lumen Field in Seattle. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl, and we've got a classic in store between the Washington football team and the Seattle Seahawks. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. For the first time with Antonio Gibson.
And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. They'll run with a former member of the Crimson Tide, Damian Harris. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has 3 options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football off a triple option, you've actually called that play.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. He's got this to the 30 before being taken down.
Oh, a lot of credit to the play caller here. He saw the design in his mind and implemented it. A little zone stretcher here because they start the tight end on the left side of the formation and set him on a crossing route. And this works really well when you can find that space between levels, and they were able to do so for good yardage.
On 1st and 10, it's Gibson. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. And officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Now Love. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. To pass, here's Jordan Love. He'll check that down to Gibson out of the backfield. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved. Just as you said, they want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
Not a touchdown, obviously, but playoffs, you're on the road. At least you put something on the board.
I would agree with that totally. You're not exactly sending a message to the opposition, but you are letting them know that you came to play.
Tyler Lockett now with a return. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. Wilson, the Seahawks take over now. First and 10 at the 33-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Wilson. He'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken.
Coming up on second and 7. Play action. Now Wilson. Sliding out of the pocket. He lets it fly for Lockett. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. A big play that time through the air. 35 yards.
Well, big plays have been a hallmark of this offense all season, so there was no reason to think that it wouldn't continue here in this title game. Obviously, the magnitude of the event, not getting to them early.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. A quick target here, complete to Metcalf.
Touchdown. Inside another move, you still don't jump around. Come on.
DK Metcalf, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Seahawks have taken the lead here in this NFC Championship game. The point after, no gimme in the snow, but it's up and good. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They'll need to come from behind if they want to play in 2 weeks as they trail early in this NFC Championship game. Jordan Love ready on first down here. He's going to look deep for more. That's caught inside the 20. And he's taken down inside the red zone, past the Seattle 15. A huge play there for Washington.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. On first down, Gibson. And a pickup of about four down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Love, they go play action now. Being chased out left. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
Nice job there defensively. A great time to dial up the blitz.
And give him credit under center instead of throwing it away. Actually, a pretty good job of getting past the line of scrimmage, not losing yardage. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And his kick is right there. It's good. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. So two first quarter field goal attempts for him, and he's converted on both.
I like the positive right there. Two for two, got the points on the board. The negative side is they didn't score touchdowns. And, of course, going forward in this game, that's going to be the aim. And hopefully they'll be kicking extra points instead.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls or setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Wilson after the play fake to Carson. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Legarius Sneed. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line.
Let's go.
Well, it's a cold night. And whether you're a quarterback that wears a glove on his throwing hand or not, that ball is a rock, Brandon. You've got to really drive it through the cold and the wind, or it can take off on you. And that may have been what happened there.
They'll run on first down. It's Gibson, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
Here's 2nd and 10. Love now. Flush to his right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. Touchdown, Washington! A great effort there. 36 yards.
And Washington has retaken the lead.
It took them a while to get their speedster involved, but they found him downfield there.
And what we've discovered as we've watched games is the speedster doesn't have to have a lot of catches, doesn't have to have volume in order to have a huge impact on the game. His speed scares the heck out of defenses, and other guys can capitalize, but when you finally hit him and he carries it all the way into the end zone, that's what you're paying him for. That big threat that can make big plays on a limited number of catches.
That's how you step on the stage with your first catch. Take it to the house. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Second and 10.
Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. He hits his target, Lockett. And they work this well upfield across the 45. In this weather, any big play in the passing game, that's just a bonus, right?
It certainly is, but oftentimes offenses think inclement weather plays to their advantage because you know where you're going on offense. Defenders have to react, and they often slip.
On first down, it's Carson, and he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, 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 and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
They go play action now. Wilson. Catch is made by Metcalf. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
And another thing that makes a comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receivers breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. A nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
They'll run on first down. Carson works his way inside the 30 on a pickup of four.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. From the shotgun, Wilson. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
We got to pick them up.
They need to get this to the 24 on third down. Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Montez Sweat with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of seven. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot.
These playoff games have a tendency to be tight. You have to wonder if that missed field goal could haunt them later.
Yeah, we're always looking for the key plays, right? The ones that we're going to magnify. Usually those happen in the second half or later in the game. This might be the key play of the game showing up here in the first half.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Here's Gibson to start the drive. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Throwing, Love. That's out to the flat for Gibson. That'll go for a gain of 7. And that's going to lead to a third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for the offense.
They'll run with Gibson. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down of the 46. And they gave themselves options there on the third down play and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
Love now to pass on first down. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8. Ahead of the chains now, 2nd and 2. On the counter, Gibson. And he will get enough for a first down, and that will lead us to the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes remain in the first half of this NFC Championship. A reminder, as we've done all year, we'll send you to Orlando for our EA Sports Halftime Report in a bit. The coach is with us per usual as we start to look ahead, Charles, to our potential matchups in this year's Super Bowl.
Break it down, coach. Break it down. We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. On first down, Gibson. Trying to get out wide, but he's going to be tackled right near the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss result.
Supposed to be in. He blew it.
So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. A handoff for Gibson. And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. On 3rd down, Love. Flushed out right. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's 4th down. Just what Seattle was hoping for. The coverage holds. And now 4th down. And his kick is indeed good. And now it's a 2-score game at 9, 16-7. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's 3 field goals for him now.
And not just 3 field goals, but 3 for 3. So even though the offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, he's still been able to come away with points due to his leg.
coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And with him down two scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. Now a nice play defensively on first down.
That's big six, guys. That's big six.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time. Separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time it was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Play action. It's Wilson. Eluding the pressure right. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. The improv act, they're good for nine, and now they'll be looking at a third and short, third and one. Here's Wilson. That's caught by his tight end, Gerald Everett. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
And now with a play clock winding down, a whistle and possibly a false start. Full start backs him up five, first and 15. They go play action with Wilson. And he cannot avoid the pressure as the Washington pass rush gets home. Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Now this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. They don't want to repeat a first down. They'll keep it on the ground. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. So we've reached halftime here in the NFC Championship as we'll send you eastward to Orlando. Standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach. All right, Coach, thank you very much as we welcome you back for quarter number three. The Halas Trophy still hangs in the balance as the second half now underway of the NFC Championship game. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And they have work to do in this second half if they want to earn that berth to the Super Bowl.
And I'm pretty sure this is where their coaches at halftime were saying don't panic and then demonstrating it by not making a lot of drastic changes to the game plan. Let's just get back to doing what we've been doing all year long. That should be more than good enough.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
Let's make these babies cry. Bam, 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 bam.
Now it's Wilson. Flush to his right. That's complete to the tight end, Everett. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you've got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll find Everett there, complete. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
And that one was a lot of fun right there, because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Throwing is Wilson. They'll run the screen with Carson. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
From the 45 on second down, Wilson. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 44-yard line.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
On first down, Wilson. Out to the right, he gets it to Lockett. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25.
It's taking a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
They'll run on first down. It's Carson, and not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Now Wilson. And this will go to Carson out wide. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. So the completion good for 7 there. And they're going to face a 3rd down. Carson, and he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
From the 13 now, they work on 1st and 10. They run it with Carson. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the 3rd quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Wilson now off the bootleg. They'll roll him out right. And it's intercepted at the goal line.
Way to make a play, Wilson.
And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And their defense just helped them out by getting the football back on the opening drive here in the second half. And now can the offense follow through with points on their first possession?
And that's a big one for them, because after the work the defense has done, they've got a chance here to open up this lead.
Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21. So, Charles, you talk about this head coach. Let's face it, this season certainly has not gone the way many had expected, or at least hoped. And I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier this week.
Yeah, we certainly did, didn't we? Because, let's face it, he's heard the whispers, and they're growing louder that he shouldn't be around next year. He essentially stormed out of that meeting you just referenced with the reporters. How did he end it? We're done here. That's a function of losing and all the pressure that's on him. Hear about pressure creating diamonds? In this case, it's bursting the pipes of the coach.
To pass, here's Jordan Love, escaping the pressure right. And that is intercepted, or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently, so that's just going to be an incompletion. Here's Tressway now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. Now it's Lockett. One quarter remains for the right to go on to the Super Bowl. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they are in need of points here, no doubt about that, with a Super Bowl berth on the line and trailing here in the fourth quarter. This possession, gigantic. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it, and it's second down.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten. To throw is Wilson. Flushed out right. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. The Seahawks on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and 10. Here's Wilson to throw. And he comes back with one complete. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
On first down. Carson, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Bringing him down there, Jonathan Allen. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top.
And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked up by Trey Brown, and they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. If they had designs of kind of wiggling their way back into this one, that hurts their chances right there.
Yeah, to put it mildly, but look at the lead, look at the deficit, trying to make a play downfield. Everyone seeking to be somewhat the hero. Didn't turn out that way at all, and you're exactly right. It's going to take a lot for them to have a chance to win this one now.
Following the interception, Love. He'll buy some time right. He completes this one to Terry McLaurin. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. A big connection on that one, 32 yards. Charles, you talk so much about quick change plays. There's one right there. You get the turnover and boom, hit him with a big one.
And defenses plan for this all the time. They work on it in practice. But in the middle of a game, when that quick change takes place, oftentimes guys aren't as focused as they need to be.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. And he will score. Touchdown, Washington. A great play there. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the interception by the Washington defense leads to a touchdown. And now the Washington offense going to stay out there and go for 2. Love throwing for it. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by DJ Reed. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 10, 5, and he takes it all the way back. It's a pick 2, if you will, as head play backfires in a big way.
Well, there's some excitement, right? Go for 2, and instead it gets picked off. And how about the return? Give him a lot of credit, though, for not giving up after the play.
Yeah, the troops rallied.
Exactly, and getting back there and making the tackle and not giving up 2 points themselves.
Wilson, the Seahawks take over now, 1st and 10 at their own 42. Wilson, after the play fake to Carson. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And that is caught, one-handed. Oh, my, he pulled it in. It's a big play there for Seattle.
They started this drive with terrific field position, and it's going to be even better after that play. Had great options with where they started, so they decided to press their advantage, and it paid off.
From the red zone now, here's Wilson on 1st down. Rolling to his right. For Kidder here, it's complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down.
Nice rhythm throw there on 1st down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Working with 2nd and 5 now. This is Carson. He'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard. In need of a conversion on 3rd down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Play action. Now Wilson. Sliding out of the pocket. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the 5 here as he's out at the 6. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the 1st, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to be what we call a flatliner. Level at everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5 there as they move closer. It's 2nd and goal.
And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise. This close.
And he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. Chris Carson taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Seahawks have made it a 1-score game again here in the 4th. Extra point right down the middle. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this 4th quarter. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. out there set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And the pressure mounting with every passing minute. It's palpable right now. They're on top in the fourth quarter, clinging to that lead. A potential Super Bowl berth resting on their ability to manage the clock and manage that small lead. Yeah, this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
You know, if following up on this head coach and the pressure that he is under, CD, I want to switch it to you because you've been on winning teams, but I know you've been in similar situations too where things just are not going well. How do you approach that as a player?
It's a tough approach, Brandon, because you actually have to do the opposite of what you would think. You know, in your mind, you're thinking, I redouble my efforts, I go harder. In a sense, you have to back off a little bit. You have to do a little bit less. Do what you're supposed to do, but don't take on the pressures of doing more and trying to do your teammates' jobs as well. If you do that, that's really going to lead you to more issues.
First down, going to the air with Love. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Love, they go play action now. And he's got his big tight end here. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. And a timeout taken. Just 6 seconds away from the two-minute warning. This defense wanted to stop the clock prior to that, and they do. A big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Throw to the right here, taken in by McLaurin. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Washington with the football here as we welcome you back. They've got a 1st and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
On 2nd down, a run with Gibson. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
He was close to flirting with that sideline, but able to stay in bounds like you know his coach wants him to do and keep that clock moving.
Isn't it funny that we're watching this play when we had that discussion just yesterday about this? What do you do in this scenario? What do you, you know, what's your mindset? It appeared to me that he'd totally forgotten that he needed to stay in bounds. And then the last second, oh, no, I better get down. And he ended up doing the right thing. But at that point, maybe close to letting it slip away.
Once more, Gibson. It's a first down and more for Gibson. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Antonio Gibson, 44 yards. And Washington going to add on to their lead.
Well, I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Lockett, the return. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
Sit on the sideline, girl, and just cheer. That's what you do.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Here's Wilson. That is caught by Smith-Schuster. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Wilson. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. And they're out of timeouts, remember, so this is going to have to be a delay. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves them back five. And now after the delay of game, they're operating behind the sticks, second and 15. Now Wilson. To the right side, incomplete to Metcalf. Calling a gain of three on the play. And they'll be facing a third and 12. Open man is Metcalf. He's got it. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 25-yard line. And what a ride it has been. NFC champs, they have punched their ticket to the biggest show in sports.
And what a way to get there, to go the entire season and then play for the right to go to the Super Bowl and the right to call themselves NFC champs. Elation has to abound.